cheat codes. Let's see what are last minute preparation tips and what is neat cutoff for this year. Okay, so first let's see cheat codes. First cheat code is avoid extreme values. So first, I would like to tell you one thing. If you are unable to cross cutoff, minimum cutoff, then only go for cheat codes. Else, don't go for cheat codes because NEET has negative marking. Remember that cheat codes are applicable only when you are unable to cross the minimum cutoff. Okay, remember this point. So now let's begin the NEET cheat codes. First cheat code is avoid extreme values. What does this mean? Avoid extreme values means, first, for example, let's think there are four options. Okay. First option is values 2, second option is 4, third option is 6, fourth option is 32. Okay. So let's think there is one question and that question has four different options and the values are 2, 4, 6, 32. And most of the students will think 32 is different from these three values. So let's put 32 as answer. This is wrong prediction. Whatever value which is very different from rest of values, that you need to avoid. Okay. So this cannot be the correct answer. Okay. So out of these three only, you need to choose one correct option. Okay. So you need to avoid different values. So in the given options, whatever option is extremely different, avoid that. Okay, this is first cheat code. Second cheat code is don't random guess, go for logical guess. Okay, so no random guess. Only go for logical guess. Okay, so first let's see what is random guess and then let's see what is logical guess. First, I'm saying you clearly no random guess. Okay, what does this mean? First, let's see what is mean by random guess. Random guess means let's think there are four questions. Okay, and after solving first three questions, you got option A as answer and don't know the answer for question 4. Okay, but after solving all the first three questions, you got option A as correct answer. So most of the students, what they does is, okay, so as first three questions options are A, maybe for fourth question option A is correct. This is called random guess. This is absolutely a wrong method. Okay, these kind of random guesses you cannot do. Okay, head, tail, these are all random guesses. These are absolutely a wrong procedure. Okay, don't go for them. Now let's see what is logical guess. Okay, what is logical guess? For logical guess means, let's think there are four options and out of four options, you are confident that A is not correct answer, B is not correct answer. You are only getting confused between B and C. You're not understanding whether B is correct answer or C is correct answer. At these particular times, use your logical guess and choose one of these B or C. Okay, this is called logical guess, and logical guess is okay to follow, but random guess is completely wrong procedure. You should not follow it. Okay, so next important cheat code is all of the above or none of the above. Okay, let's see what does this mean. For example, let's think there is a question and options. There is a question and options are 1, 4, 6, all of the above. when you don't know the correct answer for this question and when there is one of the option as all of the above, 70% of the chances are there that all of the above can be the correct answer. If you don't know the correct answer and if you have all of the above one of the option, you can go for it. This is all of the above. This is all of the above rule. Now let's see another question. There is one question and there are four options. Okay, 1, 4, 6, and option D is none of the above. See, when there is a question and when there are four options and you don't know the correct answer for this and one of the option is none of the above, there are very least possibilities that none of the above can be the correct answer. Okay, if you have like this and if you don't know the correct answer, don't go for none of the above. This is very less probability. There will be very less probability for none of the above being the correct answer. Coming to the all of the above, there will be high probability for all of the above being the correct answer. Okay, if you see have all of the above in the option and if you don't know the correct answer, go for it. If you see none of the above as the option, don't go for it. Okay. Okay. So next cheat code is using elimination method. What is elimination method? For example, let's think there is a question and four options. Option A is 1, 4, 6, 12. Okay. Use elimination method. Try to remember the concept which you know related to that question and try to start eliminating irrelevant options. Okay, so for example, using the concept of this question, I am sure that A cannot be the correct answer, C cannot be the correct answer, and you have only two options left. Okay, now what you need to do is use elimination method. Elimination method is eliminate irrelevant options. Irrelevant options. Okay. Use the concept which you know, use your logic and use your common sense and try to eliminate the options so that you will finally be left with one option and you can put that as option. Okay. So this is called elimination method. So now let's see what is NEET cutoff for this year. Now let's see what is the NEET cutoff category wise. Okay, so for OBC you must get 40 percentile and your mark should be in range between 133 to 107, and for SEST you must at least get 40 percentile and mark should be in between 133 to 107. For other categories at least 50 percentile should be the will be the and for others 50 percentile will be the cutoff. Okay, so now let's see what are the last minute preparation tips for NEET. Okay, so first important tip is don't start new topics. You have only last few days for the exam. It's better not to start new topics because if you start new topics, you will be in return very much confused, and whatever topics you have already read also, you will be confused and you'll forget them. So better don't start new topics when you have only few days left for the exam. Okay, so next is go through short notes. Whatever short notes you prepared while preparing or studying for exam, you need to go through that short notes. So next is analyze your mock test. I already told you in many videos, mock tests are very important because once you give mock tests, you'll understand how much score you are getting and where you are getting stuck and how much time you are taking for a single question and in which subjects or in which topics you're feeling it difficult to solve. All these things you can understand only while giving mock tests, only by giving mock tests, okay? So whatever mock tests you gave till now, just analyze them and make sure you don't repeat those mistakes in final exam, okay? So next tip is previous papers. I have already told you many times, 30 to 50% of 30 to 50% of similar kind of questions will be asked from the previous papers. I'm repeating my point. I'm not saying the same questions, but I'm saying similar questions. Okay, so from previous papers, similar kind of questions will be asked. So it's better to go through at least last 4 to 5 years of previous papers. Okay. So next important thing is don't study for long hours. See, if you sit and study for long hours, whatever you read will not go to your mind. In fact, you'll be bored of the subject whatever you are reading. That's why make slots, okay? For 2 hours, read a subject, 2 hours, another subject, like that. You need to keep shifting your subjects and topics. And also make sure for every 2 hours, at least take 10 to 15 minutes break, okay? Make sure you revise thoroughly whatever you have already read. Revise them, don't start any new topic. Other important tips are arrange all your essential things, that is your admit card, self-declaration form, all these kind of things, whatever are needed for exam, and put it ready the day before exam only. And next important thing is don't forget to take your mask and sanitizer, okay? And however, a new mask will be given for you in the exam hall, but you must wear your own mask also. And stop overthinking. You have worked so much hard for this particular exam. So stop overthinking. Just relax yourself. You can do it. Just be confident. And don't discuss with your friends. Don't ask them how much portion they have read and how much revision they have made. All these things will make you more and more tensed, okay? So don't discuss with your friends and maintain social distancing in the exam. It's however, NTA is taking excellent measures to make sure all the students are safe, so you need not panic about anything, okay? So yeah, future doctors, all the very best for your exam. After completion of your NEET exam, I'm going to make a NEET paper analysis video and paper discussion, and also I'm going to give you the answer key for NEET. So hope you found this video useful. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel and hit the bell icon so that you'll never miss a video from Best Way to Study. And also don't forget to like and share this video with all your friends. Thanks for watching, and all the very best to future doctors.